You see these bars on the screen? They're here to play a trick on your mind. So what is happening here? Although all the elements are 2D, it still feels like one is closer than the other. It's because the bars act as a barrier between them. And when we change the scale and the elements pass through this barrier, it makes our brain think that one element is further than the other. It's an easy way to add extra depth to your footage. So how can we do this? You will need 2 text layers and 2 shapes to start. Once you have those, it's all about the order they appear in. If you put the shape layers above the text, it will feel as if everything is on the same depth. But if you put one text layer above the shapes, it will feel as if it's closer than the one behind it. This is best used with animating the scale. Scale down the element on top and scale up the element on bottom. Then cut them both at the same place and rearrange their layer order. Put the one from bottom to the top and the one from top to the bottom. And that's the whole trick behind split depth. You can do this with real footage as well. But instead of animating the scale, it's best to use footage with one object closer than the rest. The idea is the same, make a part of the footage appear over the rectangles. To do that, we have to cut out our object. Only the parts that will appear over the shape layers need to be clean, the rest will blend in with the original footage. And our good friend Rotobrush can help us do that. If you don't like the Rotobrush, you can use masks to cut out your objects, but this can take a lot of time. Once you have the cutout, place it over the grid you created. I use mask to control how much of it I want to appear and when. And that's all there is to it, a simple way to catch your viewer's perspective off guard. You can get pretty creative with it, adding rectangles to the edges, an interface, or inside another animation, like I did with this one, which you can learn how to make right here.